ISUPK.
To the family, brother Red Pill representing No The Ledge. Do me a favor, family, make sure you subscribe to ISUPK on YouTube. Get some of that fire that the brothers are delivering, some of that good information, all right? Brah.
Destroy you, because guess what he knows? He gonna give, he got almost three million black men locked up in prison, and guess what he knows? Most of them he done gave felons. You can, listen, you can do something simple and still get, and get a damn class two felon, okay? You'll get a class two felon, all right? And guess what? It's gonna be hard for you to get a damn job, man, right? So guess what he knows? We very seldom gonna convict the black woman. We gonna give her the job and tell her that Negro ain't no damn good. Okay? Get him out your house when you got kids. When, guess what? When that black man needs you the most, guess what you should be doing? Guess what you should be doing? You should be looking out for that black man.
That's okay? Right.
Read on.
Verse 6. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion.
And guess what? He set his king upon the holy hills of Zion, man. Okay? Jesus Christ, man. Black man named Yahweh Shah. Right? And he coming back to save you up out of this hellhole that you're going through, man. Black people think this. Let me tell you something, man. Black people was living deliciously. We fled into Africa in 70 AD. Them white people came. Listen, and the damn Africans saw you. Saw you gold necklaces, chains. You had gold. You had gold, listen, Solomon had gold teeth in his mouth. The Bible say the brother had gold teeth in his mouth. You understand? All right? Guess what? Guess what the white man did? Guess what? He saw your swagger, and guess what he wanted? Guess what he wanted? I need that gold. I need this. I need this. So guess what he did? He started to kill you. We'll take him over and strip him. You know how they bought you in America? How you was dressed? How they had you on the slave ships? That wasn't how you dressed. It was against us to show our nakedness to another man. You understand? We didn't walk around with our shirts off or without no pants or anything like that. That's the white man, okay? All right, read on.
Oh, we'll come.
Okay, the white man, like I said, the white man is a goddamn devil that the Bible speak of. You might not want to believe it, but you just look what's going on in the earth, okay? All right? They just went over way over in the damn Middle East. I mean, went way over in somewhere, went over to South Korea, went in the Gulf over there, and guess what he did, man? He went over and seized the Iranian tanker. I mean, say a South Korean tanker, or Iranian tanker. It was Iranian tanker, man. Now, what the hell you think gonna happen, man? What do you think gonna happen? Okay, the white man, like I said, is a goddamn bully, man, okay? He got Hispanics on the damn border over there, got babies in a damn cage, man, by the goddamn hundreds, man, all right? How in the hell you gonna send the parents back and keep the babies? And then, come, they talking about they losing children. The white man a damn thief, you understand me, man?
Yeah.
He's a damn thief, he's stealing babies. He right back doing the same thing. And then guess what he says? That's a felon, human trafficking. Human trafficking is a felon, guess what? Well, you might as well get every damn white man a goddamn felon. You worry about Donald Trump, the damn, his tax returns. Well, goddamn it, man. Worry about the murders you're doing in the damn earth. Worry about the goddamn murder. Ain't worried about no damn tax returns. I'm worried about you murdering my people, man. You understand me, man? And you got Hispanics on the damn, on the border over there in dog cages. And then didn't think that was gonna come out. But somebody, guess what? Modern day and technology, you can't damn near do nothing and get away with it. And it's beautiful in the sight of the Lord that now black people get a real chance to see what white people are doing to black people. You thought that was a coincidence what happened to Rodney King in 1992. But guess what? You can go back through history and find out how violent the white man has been with black people. You don't see black people being violent with white people. And if you do, guess what happens? Guess what happens? He's gonna find out, and guess where you're going? Guess where you're going? Listen, they ain't gonna have your damn trial. You understand what I'm saying? Like that young boy that was up in New York, they had him up in New York talking about he committed a crime. They went and took him up there, and he was in prison for what, about 4 years? 3-4 years? And then he was in there for 3-4 years without going to trial. Like, how the hell you been in prison 3-4 years without going to trial? I thought you had to go to trial to damn go to prison. But he didn't get a trial. And you know what he did when he got out? When they finally found him through the system, they told him he got lost through the system. You're a goddamn liar, man. The white man is a goddamn devil that the Bible speak of, man. Ain't nobody getting lost in no damn prison system, man. But you didn't think he had no people, and you didn't think he had no family. You understand what I'm saying? So you took advantage of a kid that was probably about 13 to 14 years old, and you put him in a damn prison system with grown damn men. You understand me? And then when the young boy got out, the young boy killed himself. Okay? And then ain't nobody being held accountable. Okay? And we worry about some damn tax return from Donald Trump. They killing the hell out of kids in the damn street. Goddamn Donald Trump. You understand me? The Lord gonna deal with all of them. You understand me? Don't get me wrong. I don't like a damn thing about Donald Trump. You understand me, man? He's a goddamn devil too. You understand me? Read.
I will declare the decree. The Lord have said unto me.
And the Lord done declared a decree, man, on the white man, man. That decree, man, is the Lord is going to kill the damn white man. He already done declared it. You can, listen, man, you can come out here and cry all goddamn day that we want the Lord to put the white man to death. I pray every damn night that the Lord come back and put the damn white man and them little blonde haired babies to damn death. Because guess what? For 400 years, we've been trying to find peace with the damn white man, and his goddamn children been taking that same hatred that he had for you, and he keep giving it to his kids and his kids and his kids. And guess what? We got Stockholm syndrome, because guess what we doing now? We done became to have sympathy for the damn white man. Who does that? No other nation on the face of the earth have sympathy for the damn white man. If you kill them damn Arabs, they gonna fight you to the damn end. The Chinese warring up right now, they gearing up, they booting up right now. Guess what else? Everybody on the earth booting up right now against the damn white man. Guess what we doing, man? Blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. We sitting over here like some damn docile puppies. You understand? And we getting murdered the damn most. Them people don't want that to happen to their people. You understand me, man? That's why I tell a black man, gird the hell up, man. Get some balls about yourself. Get over here in this damn truth, man. And guess what? Tell the white man he's the goddamn devil to his goddamn face. Cause guess what I'm ready to do? I'm ready to die for my people. I'm ready to die for a real cause. That's real goddamn brotherhood right there, goddamn it. That's real brotherhood. And if you ain't ready to die for your damn people, guess what, man? You might as well be a coward, man. Die for your people. You already dying in America. You already dead in America. You being docile and on your damn knees, the white man ain't gonna have no sympathy for you. Got no empathy or nothing for you. Why the hell you still on your knees begging him for anything? Okay. All right. Read on.
Salakia, I will declare the decree. The Lord have said unto me, thou art my son.
And guess what? We the Lord's son, man. We the Lord's children, man. Drop that, man. Give me Psalms 36:1, man. Give me Psalms 36 and 1. It's in the same book. It's in the same book. Psalm 36 and 1. Same book. All right? You understand? Like, y'all think this is hate speech, man. Guess what, man? This is love speech, man. This love speech for black people. You understand? Hispanic people, Native American Indian people, man. All right? We tired, though. Guess what? We tired of the white man doing what he doing. You understand? Like, if you a father in this earth, if you a father in this earth, man, and something ain't, and your hairs ain't standing up on your neck, every time you see a damn white man walk by, then something wrong with you, man, okay? Because guess what, man? He's a damn mass murderer. Guess what he did, man? He just went and shot up a gang of damn children, a gang of his own damn children in Colorado. If he gonna shoot up a gang of his children in Colorado, would you think he care about you? He, listen, white people shooting up white people now, man. That's the Lord turning their spirit against them, man. Okay? That's what the Lord doing, man. I ain't telling no black person to go get no damn gun and go shoot the damn white man. You can't fight a white man with no gun. You gotta fight yourself first. You gotta fight yourself first, man. Stop smoking crack cocaine. Stop smoking weed. Stop selling your people weed. Get out of the goddamn neighborhood. Get out of the hood, making the hood goddamn dangerous to live. You understand what I'm saying? All right? Stop walking around selling your body, black woman. Stop thinking because a black man got some money. That's what makes a man. You know what makes a man? What makes a man is morals. Morals in this book right here. This is what make a real man.
That's right.
This, his obedience to the Lord. That's what makes a real man. You understand me, man? Okay? A man got money, he is the most immoral bastard on the face of the earth. He can be. You understand? But you gonna marry him for his money? You understand? Like, get a man with some dedication to the Lord and his obedience to the Lord, okay? And guess what? That relationship will last for a very long time. You understand me? Until you die. When I say very long time, that means until you die. Because according to the Bible, not the white man, once you have sex with a woman, that's your wife for life. You understand me, man? And guess what? If you was teaching that, guess how many sisters would be whores out here? Guess how many of them be out here selling their body? How many of them be out here dressing the way they dress? You know how many brothers would not throw that sister away? You understand me? Now, we gotta think about those things right there, okay? If we ain't operating in the spirit of the Lord, guess what happens, man? Guess what happens, man? We become lawless, man, okay? We don't give a damn about each other. We only become selfish when you start thinking for yourself and you're not operating in the spirit of the Lord, okay? Okay, this book right here, right, it's a manual, okay? You get a brand new car, right? You get a brand new car, you get a $180,000 vehicle, right? The first thing you do is go into the glove compartment and look at the manual. Look at the book, how to operate it. How do I put it in drive? What's this key for? How does this key, does it turn it off? Does it lock it? What kind of oil I need to put in there? How much air I need to put in the tires? What kind of gas I need to put in this car? You start looking at all those things, and guess what? You'll have that car for a very long time. So here's what it is with this Bible, man. This Bible is the same thing, man. It's your manual on how to live, okay? Not how to die, okay? You got Psalms 36 and 1? Give me 36 and 1, man, okay? But I'm gonna tell you this. The reason why we don't go by this book is because we've been deceived by the white man to believe that God loves you no matter what. When the Lord is angry with you if you commit a sin, right? So the white man, he devises mischief against you, okay? All right, read on.
So, chapter 36, verse 1. The transgression of the wicked saith within my heart.
And the transgression of the wicked saith within their heart. Read.
That there is no fear.
There's no what?
No fear.
And guess what? Ain't this the Christian church? God loves you no matter what. God loves you no matter what. So guess what happens? So the Most High can't be bad with you. He can't be angry with you if you do anything. So why would the Most High say you should fear him? Why do the Most High want you to fear him? He said, I'm a terrible and a fearsome God, right? Right? He is terrible, right? That's what the Lord said. Guess what? When you see all these tsunamis and hurricanes and all these fires come out of nowhere, man, believe me, it ain't Mother Nature. Believe me, it ain't got a damn thing to do with Mother Nature. You know what that is, man? That's the Lord, man. That's how the Lord operates. The Lord controls everything in the earth. You understand me? There ain't nothing happening in the earth without the Lord knowing. Even Satan himself, if he wants to do anything in the earth, he has to go ask the Most High. If you ever read the Bible, you read in Job, the first chapter, they tell you that that Satan has a report to the Most High. And if you think Satan and the Most High is fighting in heaven like these, like the damn white man tell you, Christians tell you, man, you're a goddamn idiot, man. You understand me saying? How the hell do you gonna be fighting with the Most High? Just admit that you have the Lord the Most High. You have the Lord the Most High, okay? Okay? Read.
That there's no fear of God.
There's no what?
Fear of God.
There's no what?
Fear of God.
And that's what the Christian church teaches, that there's no fear of God. No matter what you do, Lord ain't mad with you. God ain't mad with you. That's a damn lie, man. That's a damn lie, man. That's just an evil, wicked damn white boy, right? That's trying to get you to go against your power. You understand me? It's just like your father. If your father say, son, I don't want you to smoke dope. Don't let me catch you smoking dope, right? Right? But your friend's gonna try to tell you, it's okay. Weed ain't never hurt nobody. You understand what I'm saying? Weed ain't never hurt nobody. But that's a lie. You get on weed and guess what? You might make it to the front door. You might make it to the front damn door. You see all these youngins walking through here, how the top of their damn dome, don't know what's happening. Guess what happened? DC got took off of Negroes being damn high. You understand me?
Trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, but it's guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With